cancer survivors through my Pilates and specifically some of the pink ribbon training programs that we do. And I can tell you that I always learn more from them than I think that they learn from me. And so today what I wanted to share with you is just a story of kind of a great example of that. I'm hoping that this story will give you a sense of why movement and the Pilates method of exercise is my life passion. And kind of what maybe through this story that it'll inspire you to look at your own movement and exercise program in a whole new way. So my story today is about a breast cancer survivor. She is a breast cancer survivor who had a double mastectomy and reconstruction. And I saw her probably about a year after she was finishing up her therapies. And this story that I'm going to share with you today really took place a good, 2 to 3 months after her and I had been starting to go through it. The session started a very normal session. So when I'm working with a client, I really like to check in with people and kind of take a moment in our beginning of our session and just say, hey, how's your body feeling today? You know, is anything hurting? Did you feel okay from last session? What's going on? It gives me kind of a standpoint to start my session so I kind of know where we're going to go. And on this particular day, she kind of just looked at me and she had this really big excited smile on her face. And she kind of said, you know, I've been waiting to tell you this story. And really excited. And I said, well, you know, what happened? And she looked at me and she said, you know, Carey, I went to go put my seatbelt on the other day ago in the car. And she's like, I had this moment when I realized that my arm didn't hurt. And she said, and then throughout my day, I kind of was aware that, you know, like when I went to reach to give something to my kids in the backseat of the van, it didn't hurt anymore. And I, you know, could grab something from the shelf, and I had this range of motion that I didn't have anymore. And she was, you know, really excited, and I was really excited. I call these, moments life moments. And I want to take a moment and just talk a little bit about life moments. To me, my life moments are kind of these moments when you're going along day to day, doing maybe the stuff you have to do, maybe the stuff you want to do, playing with your kids, grandkids, whatever, and you have that realization that I'm doing something that I couldn't do before. I'm doing something that maybe I couldn't do before without pain. And it's very exciting. Oftentimes I hear things from clients like, I went out and shoveled 3 inches of snow off the driveway and my back didn't hurt. Or my grandkids came over to play, you know, and they're 2 and they're 4 and I got to play on the floor with them. And I played with them, and I got up, and I was fine, and my back didn't hurt, my knees didn't hurt, and it was amazing. Or when I went on vacation, walked 2 or 3 miles, and I didn't even realize it. So these are what I would call life moments. And I, as an instructor, I really love to celebrate life moments with my clients. Oftentimes at first, when people kind of tell me about them, they're a little bit shy because it seems a little bit silly. Luckily my seatbelt didn't hurt. But, you know, from my standpoint, from their standpoint, it's a pretty big deal, okay? And when they see that I'm excited, they get excited as well. These life moments, these moments of kind of living life to the fullest or being able to do what you do or want to do without pain and without thinking about it, it's really why I'm so passionate about helping others move. It's really why I have my own movement and exercise practice, because I want to be able to do that, but also that I can help others. I specifically use the Pilates method of exercise to teach people and inspire them to use movement to enrich their life. So back to my story, that was my life moment story. So I was having this wonderful moment with my client, and I was very excited, and she was very excited, and I was saying, yes, you know, we're strengthening, you're creating flexibility, and you're not pain anymore, and it's awesome. And she kind of looked at me, and she said, Carey, she said, I don't think you understand, how big this is, how big of a move on with this life. And of course I do. Like, I get it. Like, I love, you know, I'm excited. And she was, once again, kind of looked at me and said, Carey, no, really. And she said, you know, I have spent over a year fighting cancer. And I have spent ever since then trying to get my life back to normal. And she just said, you know, I want to be a mom. I want to be a wife. I want to enjoy my kids and watch them grow up. And quite frankly, I don't want to have to think about it anymore. And it's very hard to get on with life when every time you turn around, there's a reminder. Those pills she said I have to take every day, even though they're saving my life, they remind me. The weight that I can't seem to lose or take off, it reminds me. And the pain when I go to buckle my seatbelt or do something else, it's a reminder. And she said, you know, it reminds me. It reminds me of the pain that I went through, that my family went through. It reminds me of that fear that I might not be there for my kids. That fear that it might come back.